Hello all, I welcome you all to this session of basic thermodynamics. We have derived temperature relations for different scales. Now we will try to solve few problems on the same. The first problem which we are considering is the temperature T in a thermometer scale is defined by the relation T is equal to A ln P plus B. Remember, when we were considering the deriving the equations for temperatures for different scales, we had taken that temperature is a linear function of the thermometric property. But however, here it is following a different relation. So, the relation he has given is A ln P plus B, where temperature T in a thermometer scale is defined by the relation T is equal to A ln P plus B, where A and B are constants. Experiment gives the values of P as 1.86 and 6.81 at ice point and steam point respectively. So, at ice point, he is giving you the value of P. Let us denote P as Pi and the value is 1.86. At steam point, let us denote it by P suffix S, the value is 6.81. Evaluate the temperature T on a Celsius scale. So, he is trying to tell you that this is a Celsius scale. So, at ice point, temperature T in a Celsius scale is 0 degree Celsius, and at steam point, temperature is, let us denote it as T suffix S. We know that in a Celsius scale it is 100 degree Celsius. So, we have these values. Now, what he is asking you, corresponding to a reading of P is equal to 2.5, evaluate the temperature T. So, if you want to do that, we need to have the values of A and B. So, we will try to solve for A and B. We know the conditions. We'll solve by the conditions at ice point. Let us call this as equation 1. At ice point, we know that Ti is equal to 0 degree Celsius and Pi is 1.86. Go for substituting it here. 0 is equal to A ln Pi. At ice point, it is 1.86 plus B. Call this as equation 2. Now, at steam point, we know also at steam point, temperature is 100, A ln Ps is 6.81 plus B. Call this as equation 3. Now, solve equation 2 and 3 to get the values of A and B. Solving equation 2 and equation 3, our equation 3 minus 2, what we get is 100 minus 0 is equal to A ln 6.81 minus A ln 1.86. So, in both the terms B will get cancelled out. Therefore, 100 is equal to, take out A as common, ln of 6.81 minus ln of 1.86. So, ln A minus ln B is equal to ln A by B. So, you get ln of 6.81 divided by 1.86 is equal to 100. If you solve this equation, you get the value of A as 77.05. Now, substitute this value in equation 2 to get the value of B. Therefore, 0 is equal to, substitute A value in equation 2, 0 is equal to 77.05 ln 1.86 plus B. Solve this equation, you get the value of B as -47.81. Now what we have got? We have got the value of A and B. Go back here, substitute the value of A and B in equation 1. Substitute A and B value in equation 1. What we get is T is equal to 77.05 ln P plus, here it is, the value of B is -47.81. So this is the equation we wanted. So if you evaluate the temperature T on a Celsius scale corresponding to a reading of P is equal to 2.5. If you substitute the value of P as 2.5, you get the temperature corresponding to the value of P is equal to 2.5. That is, temperature is equal to 77.05 ln 2.5 -47.81. So, temperature you get it as 22.78 degrees Celsius. You can relate it here. See, what he is trying to give you, 1.86 is the value of thermometric property when it is at 0 degree Celsius, and it is 6.81 at 100 degree Celsius. Now what we are trying to find out? At 2.5. So obviously at 2.5 it should be between 0 and 100 degree Celsius. That is what we can estimate. So by that logic, this answer looks okay. We'll solve the problem number 2. The reading TA and TB of two Celsius thermometers A and B. So there are two thermometers, namely A and B. The temperature corresponding to thermometer A, we are denoting it by T suffix A. Temperature corresponding to B thermometer, we are denoting it by T suffix B. Agree at ice point and steam point. We know that it is a Celsius scale. So we know ice point in a Celsius scale is 0 degree Celsius, and steam point in a Celsius scale is 100 degree Celsius. So there are two thermometers, A and B. Temperature corresponding to A is T suffix A. Temperature corresponding to B is T suffix B. Both A and B agree at ice point and steam point. If you have two thermometers, if you keep both the thermometers at ice point, they both agree, means both of them will show 0 degree Celsius. And also at steam point, if you keep both the thermometers in the steam point, both of them will show 100 degree Celsius. That is what it means. Both agree at ice point and steam point. But elsewhere, they are related by equation TA is equal to L plus MTB plus NTB square. So this is the relationship between temperature in thermometer A and temperature in thermometer B. See, this difference can happen because of the thermometric property. If you have one as a mercury thermometer and one as an alcohol thermometer, both can be calibrated at 0 and 100 at ice point and steam point. But elsewhere in between, the temperature may not match. It depends purely on the thermometric property, that is the expansion. So alcohol may expand differently at a certain temperature, whereas mercury can expand differently at different temperatures. Because of this, there may be a difference between, that is, elsewhere they agree at ice point and steam point, but elsewhere they are related by this equation. So there is a difference where, so we will write down this equation. T suffix A is the temperature in thermometer A is equal to L plus M T suffix B plus N T B square. Call this as equation 1, where L, M and N are constants. when both thermometers were immersed in a system of fluid, A registers 11 degree Celsius and B registers 10 degree Celsius. So, I have given one more condition. When A registers 11 degree Celsius, B registers 10 degree Celsius. Now, determine the reading on A when B registers 37.4. So, that is what we are trying to solve. First, what we will do, we know few conditions. At ice point, both T and TB will be is equal to 0 because it agrees at ice point and steam point. At steam point, TA and TB also is equal to 100 degree centigrade, same condition. And one more condition he has given, at 11 degree Celsius, when it is showing, at A it is showing 11, B will show 10 degree Celsius. We know that this difference is because of the expansion property, may be different for different fluids. So, now we will try to solve this. At ice point, what we know is temperature will be equal to 0 degree Celsius and TA is equal to TB. So, 0, TA is equal to TB is equal to 0 is equal to L plus M TB is 0 plus N TB square, that is 0 square, once again 0. So, whole term you will get the value of L is equal to 0. So, you got the constant value L is equal to 0. Similarly, you go for steam point. At steam point temperature TA is equal to TB is equal to 100 because it agrees at steam point and ice point. In both the condition TA and TB agrees, right? So, 100 degree Celsius, substitute this in equation 1. What we have, TA is 100, L is 0 which we have found out, plus M into TB is 100 plus N into 100 square. So, you solve this equation, 100 is equal to, or you can take 100 common out here, 100 into M plus 100 N. So, both this term will get cancelled, here you will remain with 1. So, what will remain here is M is equal to 1 minus 100 N. So, we got the value of M as 1 minus 100 N. So, we have used two conditions, that is TA is equal to TB is equal to 0 and one more boundary condition was TA is equal to TB is equal to 100. So, we ended up with L is equal to 0, but whereas here there are two unknowns which we cannot solve, we may have to use one more condition which he has given, when TA is 11, TB is 10. So, substitute this value in equation 1. TA is equal to 11, should be equal to L which we have found out 0, plus M value as 1 minus 100 N, TB which we know that is 10, plus N into TB square, that is 10 square, or simply you can write it as 100. So, multiply this and simplify. 11 is equal to 10 minus 1000 N plus 100 N. Our 11 minus 10 here, you will have 1 is equal to minus 900 N. Our N is equal to minus 1 by 900. So, we get the value of N. Go back here, substitute the value of N to get the value of M. So, substitute N value, let us say this as equations 2, N value in equation 2, what we get is M is equal to 1 minus 100, N value as 1 by 900. So, you will have 1 minus 1, this will become plus 1 by 9. Or it is 9 plus 1 by 9 or it is 10 by 9. So value of m is equal to 10 by 9. We got the value of m, we got the value of n, and we got the value of l. So we will substitute all the values, constant values in equation 1. Substitute l, m, and n value in equation 1. Ta is equal to l is 0 plus m is 10 by 9 tb plus n is minus 1 by 900. So you can take this out, minus 1 by 900 tb square. So this is the relationship we have got now. Now what is the question? Determine the reading on A when B registers 37.4. So substitute 10 by 9, 37.4 TB value, minus 1 by 900, 37.4 square. We simplify this value and get 40 degree Celsius. Now it is quite evident that, you know, when TA is showing 11, TB is showing 10 degree Celsius. That means to say TA and TB should be nearer to each other because they both agree at ice point and steam point, and there cannot be much of difference. But what here it is showing that TB should be less than that of TA, that is what we know. So now when TB is showing you 37.4, TA is showing 40 degree Celsius, seems to be okay with the solution. Problem number 3. Sir Isaac Newton proposed a linear temperature scale. Linear. So he is telling you the relationship between temperature and thermometric property follows a linear temperature scale. So T is equal to AL plus B, wherein ice point and normal human body temperature were assumed as two fixed points. See, whenever you know, so we talked about Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale, Rankine, Kelvin scale. So in all of them, the reference points were ice point, steam point, sometimes it was brine solution, sometimes it was absolute zero temperature. So here he is taking ice point as one reference temperature and normal human body temperature as another reference temperature. And he has fixed two points and assigned the temperature as 0 and 12. So let us call this as a Newton scale. Let us denote it by T suffix N. At ice point, temperature is 0, you can call it as 0 Newton or simply 0. And at normal human body temperature, at normal human body temperature, you can call this as T suffix I, you can denote it as T suffix B, he is getting 12. So 0 Newton and 12 Newton as two fixed points and assign the temperature. If the temperature of the body on a Fahrenheit is 98 degree Fahrenheit, obtain the relationship between Newton and Fahrenheit scale. So we will have to obtain the relationship between Fahrenheit scale and Newton scale. First, what we will do, we will solve it for Newton scale. Let us assume that we are solving for Newton scale first, then we will solve it for Fahrenheit scale. So at ice point, we know that it is 0. 0 is equal to A L suffix I plus B. Let us say L at ice point is denoted by L suffix I. So 0 is equal to A L I plus B. Similarly, at human body temperature, substitute these conditions. Let us say L is equal to L suffix B. you are denoting it as 12. Substitute this in equation 1. 12 is equal to A L suffix B plus B. Call this as equation 3. Solve equation 2 and 3. What we get is 12 minus 0 is equal to A L suffix B minus A L suffix I. B term will get cancelled out. A is equal to 12 divided by L suffix B minus L suffix I. Okay. Substitute the value of A in equation 2. Substitute value of A in equation 2. 0 is equal to 12 divided by LB minus LI L suffix I plus B. You get the value of B is equal to minus 12 LI divided by LB minus LI. Now go for substituting the value of A and B in equation 1. Substitute A and B value in equation 1. Newton scale temperature is equal to 12 divided by LB minus LI L minus 12 L suffix I LB minus LI. Our Newton scale is equal to, take this common out, LB minus LI L minus LI. This is the expression for new scale, that is Newton scale, keeping 0 as ice point and 12 as human body temperature. Now we will go for Fahrenheit scale. What we know Fahrenheit scale? At ice point, we already know Fahrenheit reads 32 Fahrenheit, and let us denote L as L suffix I. So, T, substitute these values in equation 1. Substitute in equation 1, 32 is equal to A Li plus B. Similarly, at human body temperature, he has given Fahrenheit scale as 98 degree Fahrenheit. At human body temperature, temperature is 98 degree Fahrenheit. So, 98 is equal to A suffix L suffix B. So, we are denoting L as L suffix B at human body temperature plus B. Call this as equation 4. And equation 5. Solve equation 4 and 5. That is equation 5 minus equation 4. So, you have 66, that is 98 minus 32 is equal to A L B minus A L I. B will get cancelled out. A into L B minus L I is equal to 66. Or A is equal to 66 divided by LB minus LI. We got the value of A. Substitute the value of A in equation 4. 32 is equal to A as 66 divided by LB minus LI into LI plus B. Our B is equal to minus 66 L suffix I LB minus LI plus 32. We got the value of A and B. Substitute the value of A and B in equation 1. Substitute value of A and B in equation 1. That is, temperature is equal to A is 66 by LB minus LI L plus B, that is minus 66 LI divided by LB minus Li plus 32. Or you can take this common out, 66 L minus Li divided by Lb minus Li plus 32. So this is Fahrenheit scale. So same linear relationship. So T is equal to Al plus B we have taken. Now we have to find out the relationship between Newton scale and Fahrenheit scale. Look at here. If you try to put this expression here, you will get the Newton scale here. That is what we will try to do. If you multiply and divide by 12 here, it does not change the meaning of this expression. So we can write this expression as 66 into 12 and divide by 12, L minus Li divided by Lb minus Li plus 32. Now look at this expression. 12 into L minus Li divided by Lb minus Li is nothing but Newton scale. 66 by 12 is here only. This is the relationship between Fahrenheit scale and the Newton scale given these conditions. Thank you.